Joining us now, he is the head coach of the Mustangs, Coach Paul Cantabene. Coach, we said normally we'd be not thrilled. Yeah, right? Cal's here, so you got to get up.
What's
there.
What's up, buddy?
How you doing, mate?
Good to see you.
Normally we wouldn't love loud music bumping, but we're going to let you have a pass because was a big, big one, and you guys deserve to celebrate it accordingly. Can you just sort of take me through everything you guys have been through to start the season and then getting a win like this tonight?
Well, you know, it's our sixth game, right? We're 1-5, but it's our fifth top five team, you know? I mean, so I think our guys understand how to play in these games, and I give them a lot of credit. You know, they really did a great job. They came out early, put a lot of pressure on Cabrini, playing really well. Cabrini made a great run at us in the second half. We took it and got some plays to win the game, and that's a really talented offensive team, and, you know, holding them to 10 goals is a lot. You know, they do a great job, and I think, you know, defensively they're pretty solid, and, you know, Justin Brunetti faced off great today, which we really needed, and did a great job. But, you know, it feels great. Told them to enjoy because they really worked hard. I think their attitudes have been so great all year. They have never hung their heads and really just stood up and got a tough win when they needed it. They're a bunch of tough kids, you know what I mean? I think it's great, and for us just playing so tough and getting it down the stretch was great because we've wilted a couple times in the 5 minutes ago giving up some things. And but it's a good win, and, you know, beating the number three, whatever they are, and it's a great win for us. And but we gotta move on from it. I told them enjoy it, but hopefully we can get a couple more next week and a couple more the week after that and start getting back on track here.
Yeah, Coach, first of all, congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you, Caleb.
Alumni,
thank
you. You know, I love seeing it. First one of the season. I hope it means a lot more to come.
Yes.
Glenn was asking me, you know, up in the box, is there anything you can do? Is there anything you can put your finger on prior to the game, pregame, leading up this week? Is there anything you changed that maybe, you know, come up with the win for Stevenson tonight?
Well, I think that, you know, we practice a little harder than we usually do. And, you know, a pregame for us is pretty light. And we went pretty hard actually yesterday because of the snow and stuff. We thought we needed to go a little bit. But I thought some of the changes we made. You know, Ethan playing attack pretty much the whole game. Jacob Tatum playing attack pretty much the whole game. I think that really helped us in that spot. Even though Colin Mason's done a good job. We saw it came through the box a little bit, playing some midfield at times. We just need to get a little bit more out of that position. So we thought we had to make those choices. And I thought the young guys did a good job. You know, Colin Tucker, unfortunately, was playing well until he got popped there, which is a huge hit. And but Danny Buckwalter played well, and Chris Hammerquist got his chance to play well and gave us an opportunity. And those are good guys that haven't played as much. So I think those changes did a lot. But I think the biggest thing for our guys is that they just don't give up. You know, I think, you know, with our attitude here is that, you know, we play a great schedule and we might lose a few here or there, but we're going to learn how to win a few as well. And I think we got that. And playing that great schedule we did prepared us for this victory today. And but I give Cabrini a lot of chance. I think they're coached really well. And I mean, a lot of credit. I think they're coached really well and they play really hard. You know, they're a tough bunch of kids. And, you know, they scored some tough goals tonight. But I thought at the same time, you know, Drew Costco, who nobody mentioned, held his guy scoreless. You know, Timmy Brooks loves us. I think we're his best team ever. He scored like a billion goals against us. And Drew held him scoreless tonight. And that was a great thing, really being in his, really being right on him all the time. And he made some tough ground balls and just played really well. So Drew Costco was really an excellent player for us tonight. That was great.
I thought there were a lot of guys that had great efforts. You mentioned Justin, who was brilliant tonight. But even Sam Ross, as the second half went along, you needed a few of those. And he came up with some really big ones.
We did. We're so young there. You know, Austin Howard's really a pole and he's doing a great job at close for us, and Drew really getting a couple starts on him. He hasn't really played a ton for us in the past, and then playing Falco, who hasn't played so much, and, you know, Kevin McCarthy scores the 14th goal in there. You know, we got a freshman in there in the end and making a play for us, and, you know, we just got a lot of young kids playing for us for the first time, and we got to live with them, and they've done some good things and they're starting to respond, and we're really happy for them. You know, I'll sleep a lot better. I think my wife's going to be really happy with me now because I haven't really been a nice person for about 4 weeks here, but so it'll be
train check fired up tonight.
Those O'Gay's trains will be flying around the corner tonight, full speed, baby. But you know, but it's great. And I'm really, really happy about the whole thing. And you know, just to get one, and we got to look forward. But the guys worked hard for it. You know, when you work hard for a victory, you got to enjoy it.
Yeah, I think no one could have foreseen the injuries and some of the setbacks we've had coming into this season. Yeah. You know, what do you say to these young guys who now have the opportunity to get out under the lights? They've been, you know, chasing it on the paddock and the practice field for a long time. What do you say to them coming into a game like tonight to really seize the opportunity?
Well, I first have to make them understand what a paddock is. I'm not sure what that a paddock is. I'm not sure what that is, but I'll find out what that is. But
do you know about the elephant? Do you understand how to eat an elephant? I've learned a lot from Cal.
It's amazing, isn't it?
Yeah.
So for somebody who didn't know the rules for the first 2 years here. But
first 3 years.
But I think we just give those guys an opportunity to play. You know, we tell them, hey, you got a chance to make an impact here at a young age. Not a lot of kids get to do that, especially the freshmen and the sophomores who are playing for the first time. And they see an opportunity on the wall to contribute to us. And I think that's great. When you know, kids really step up and you give them an opportunity to contribute and give them their 5 minutes of fame and they make the most of it, you know, they stay there. They don't. They got to work a little harder to get their chances back. And like Chris Hammerquist today, I thought he played well. You know, he hasn't played a whole lot for us because we didn't think he was ready, but we gave him an opportunity today, and I thought he played great, you know.
Absolutely.
And, you know, Colin Mason got a couple chances, even though he's played a lot for us. I thought he did a good job. You know, Ethan Christensen's been absolutely wonderful for us all year. You know, he's done just an unbelievable job controlling everything for us. But you get those younger guys, McCarthy and McGow, and, you know, all those guys that get in there, and Falco, you know, good story about him. He said he wanted to quit like a week in. It was like, you're not quitting. You know, you're not quitting. You're just not doing it. And he didn't. But now all of a sudden he wasn't playing the first game. Now he's played a ton in the last four games. So, you know, just hard work pays off. And for kids nowadays, a lot of them think things have to come easy. They have to, you know, if I don't start as a freshman, I'm never going to play. And, you know, the millennials out there, they're my favorite people in the world. You know, hard. You got to work hard. You know, you got to work hard to play and do things and put in a position to make plays when we need that. And a lot of the kids, we tell them, like, you know, we need kids to make plays when the score is 10-10 in the fourth quarter. We need kids to make plays to help us win. If you're that type of kid, we'd love to have you. And I think kids understand that's what they want with us, and we work hard with them, and they're a great bunch of kids, and I'm really happy for them.
Absolutely.
Coach, before we bring JT in here, do you want to let Cal know that because you guys played so well tonight, he's going to have to do a few more of these this season?
Cal understands that already. I don't have to tell him
it
that.
Is, baby,
I don't have to tell him that. Cal's fully aware.
Hey, Coach, congratulations on a huge win tonight. We'll see you on Tuesday. All right.
Thank you very much.
He is Coach Paul Cantabene joining us here in the All Access Postgame Show.